144. Chapter 28. Final Straw. As they enter the playing field, Bob takes a deep breath, then lets the lady go first. Sophie cracks her knuckles and stations her throne. Bob looks to Ingrid, then Charlie, and then Robert. Stop. Victor snatching him away from the dizzying daze that Sophie had planted in his brain. A mind already deluged with the unanswered promises of a tomorrow's dawn, of what could be, and what would never spawn. A mind filled with flashes of fear, filled with sorrow, pain, and tears. Calliope's of visions danced in his head, of fatherly passions, of joys and of dread. Days suspended in frolic and play, a kiss from the rainbow, a kiss from the day. For these are the these that will never be tasted, never be sung, never be wasted. Panorama like visions of purple and blue, red ones and green ones, and yellow ones, too. Our hero leaves daunting for all that take heed, to wind and to thistle, to worm and to weed. Woe to be fallen, woe to be men, woe to be risen, woe to be then. With scepter raised high, honed crisp for the battle, he cries to his vespers of chattel. A poet, a sage, a man for the age. A winner, a loser, a champ for a day. Make haste to him now, go with great speed, in his hour of want, in his hour of need. Cry for our hero, cry for his joy, cry for his widow, cry for his boy. He leaves us his blessings, for she and for he, his weight of salvation, is on you and on me. 145. Spirit of Jacob, spirit of Paul, course through his mantles, through rise and through fall. Who amongst us would falter or question this creed? He is called to his altar, he is called to this deed. With angels of fury, to beckon his call, his might and his wisdom shall carry us all. On the wings of the eagle, on the wings of the dove, the hero amongst us gives all his love. Go to him now, go to his aid, with sickle, with shovel, with hoe, and with spade. His testament etched in stone and in pages, for these are the scrolls of seers and sages. Bob looks up to the big clock on the wall over the bleachers, 10:59 p.m., then drops his gaze onto her brow, her face, her heart, her belly, her frown. Tears welled up from out of her eyes. Cries of love's passions poured down from her skies. Be strong, my dear love, find strength from above, ride wings of the eagle, ride wings of the dove. It's 11 o'clock, Robert. Time to kick ass. We need you to focus, you need to think fast. Robert. I took the liberty last night, while you were sleeping, to load crucial data onto your flash card. It contains everything that you will need to ascend into the clouds. Here, take it and put it in your pocket, it has a port adapter attached. Mr. Dyer, the match has started. Miss Sophie won the coin toss, and she chose for you to go first. Robert, Mr. Dyer, you are white, the timer started at 11 o'clock. The clock is ticking. Sir, it is your move, the floor manager warns. What? Victor. What were you saying? 146. Bob was dangerously close to slipping into a complete spiritually emotional, existential level, crippling meltdown. A crash, a burn, at just one turn, appeared to be imminent. The Hindenburg was drifting dangerously close to the power lines. Robert, if you sense that Sophie may be gaining advantage or leading you into a stalemate, insert the flash drive adapter plug into your phone. It will send out a silent signal of nanowave particles that will disrupt her processes. With this device in place, a silicon chip inside her head will switch to overload. I also took the liberty to install another self-loading program on the flash drive. It has a failsafe built into it. Mr. Dyer, please, the clock is ticking. It's 2 minutes past 11 o'clock, sir. Please sit down. The whole world is watching, the whole world, Mr. Dyer. Bob pulls his face away from Victor's, and as if in slow motion, spinning at 8 RPMs on a turntable. He spins himself around, seeing all the players, all the witnesses, all the eyes of the world set upon him. He sees all the players, all the champs, all the judges, and all the tramps, then launches a love bomb up and into the bleachers, a current, a wave, a projectile of laser beam focus, up and into the depths of her soul, into every fiber, into all her being. I am ready, my love, we are ready in love. The blood of my blood, the flesh of my flesh, the seed of my seed, the nectar of the steed, a stallion in service and need. In her with him shall carry the blood of the sacred grail, poured out from above. Mr. Dyer, 55 minutes left. Sir, make your move. 147. I know, do not tell me what time it is, sir. He in his throne, set cut to the bone, to the queen of the snake. For the serpent bemoan. It is the seed of Satan itself. 148. Cut. 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 Jackie, turn them lights back on. Jack, what just happened to the film? Why didn't we get Tar see the last chapter? Damn projector dad left here keeps eating up those memories. Your endgame got chewed up last time we rolled it. Sorry, Robert. Teddy started crying. It was his favorite scene. Can't say as I blame him. Was a real tearjerker for sure. Luckily, Marilyn knew how to convert it to MPEG just in the nick of time. It is up in the cloud there now and forever. Jack, do you think Bobby can handle it? What if Bobby can't handle the truth? It's kinda gruesome, especially the end part, when. Robert, you sure you wanna see this? Sure, Jack, I can take it. I know the ending anyways. Besides, still some Pop Khan left. Can we watch the Zapruder again right after this? Jackie, turn them lights off again, will you, darling? Roll M if you got M.